Here, just like in the rest of the world, the car is a symbol of freedom and success. But there's a little problem. If everyone wanted to have a car like here in the US, we'd go from 800 million cars to 5 billion. And the Chinese have just such a dream. Imagine every day 1,500 new cars are registered in Beijing. Cars have replaced bicycles, and the capital is blighted by pollution. Watch this.
15 years ago, Beijing looked like this. A paradise for bikes, the symbol of communist China. This is how it looks today. The Chinese capital has become dominated by the automobile. 3.5 million cars, six beltways, highways right in the center of town, and hundreds of kilometers of traffic jams. The modern dream is turning into a nightmare. One new car hits the streets every minute. The city is reaching saturation point. We're in the center of Beijing, in Chuenwu. Zhang Wei was born and spent nearly his whole life here. But today, this 32-year-old man is struggling to recognize his old neighborhood.
Zhang
Wei is one of the victims of the automotive boom. His family has received 40,000 euros from the government, an insufficient sum to buy an apartment in the center of town. So today, Zhang Wei's family is living in a suburb an hour and a half from here. Ironically, to get around, he's also had to buy a car. Every weekend, hundreds of Beijing inhabitants follow suit. In the south of town, there's a 200,000 square meter emporium entirely dedicated to the Chinese new passion. China's economic boom has boosted buying power. Having a car is now a priority. Gas-guzzling 4x4s and big cylinders are all the rage, and some are willing to go that extra mile to get the car of their dreams. That's the equivalent of 4.5 years worth of salary in Beijing, but nowadays there are cars for every budget. Mr. Liu is a 40-year-old and earns 350 euros a month. Despite his modest salary, he's buying his first car today. A QQ, the least expensive on the market. It only costs 4,000 euros. Today, only 2% of the Chinese population has a car, but demand for oil is already skyrocketing. The nation consumes nearly 8 million barrels per day. If the number of cars per inhabitant reaches that of the US by 2030, China will need all of the oil products on Earth. How will it meet such demand, and what will the consequences be for the climate? China is already the number one carbon dioxide emitting country. Beijing is one of the world's most populated cities. The pollution there is reportedly 7 times higher than in Paris. For the past 25 years, Dr. Ro Ping has been heading the respiratory diseases unit in one of the city's largest hospitals. She's very concerned by the impact of cars on the population. The pollution of the cities due to cars as well as factories and coal claims at least 400,000 lives in China each year. But nothing can stop the automotive freight train, a revolution that's synonymous with progress. The Western way of life has become a model for Beijing residents. They've even discovered drive-ins, a popular phenomenon in the US in the 1950s. An open-air cinema where you watch the screen while sitting in your car. The Chinese fascination with the automobile tonight culminates with some of them watching a film about cars from their cars. The automobile has become a religion, imposing sacrifices. Topping the list are the city center's old neighborhoods, known as hutongs. They're the final battlements against the automotive invasion. We join Zhang Wei, who's devoted his life to protecting these threatened neighborhoods ever since his house was destroyed. There are dozens of neighborhoods under threat in Beijing. Zhang Wei takes us to a hutong that's currently being destroyed. This is a sensitive subject, and journalists are not welcomed. We must therefore film discreetly. Today, Beijing is sacrificing part of its history for what might just be a brief automotive moment. What will happen when there's no more oil? Some people in the Chinese capital are searching for solutions. Wang Yong is a businessman who made his fortune in the restaurant trade. To resolve the car problem, this defender of the environment decided to inspire himself from his childhood.
When I was a teenager, we live on the bikes. You know, every day we go to school, we go to work, we have to use the bicycle every day.
Our dream is that someday Beijing will become back the city of bicycle.
To this end, Wan Yong invested 3 million euros and in 2005 created a company renting bicycles. 2 years before France, he invented the Vélib bike rental system. By charging a very low fee, he wants to encourage the population to abandon the car. Today, he owns 100 stations in Beijing, like this one. Last year, he had 1 million clients. However, despite his success, Wan Yong isn't making any money from this endeavor. Yet he pursues it because of his convictions.
If we continue to increase the car numbers, it will cause a lot of problems, like what happened in the Western cities. We should learn, from the other cities. We all have the responsibility to help to protect the environment, to save the earth.
We can't stop India and China from embracing our way of life. We are a model for the world, but we all know there won't be enough oil for everybody.